Thank you, Mr. Speaker, sir. And thank you to the Honourable Member for the question and for stepping in for the Honourable Ngavoka. Quality control of roads and improvement of roads. The Fiji Roads Authority, which has the responsibility for the road network for almost around 7,000 kilometres, bridges, streetlights and jetties, has in place its quality control measures to try to ensure the quality of the assets that it has. And in doing this, there are a number of things that it looks at, that it tries to do. One, it has standards in place. So it tries to establish quality control through standards. It has mechanisms in place. One, for instance, is the compliance to the roadwork standards and specifications. These standards and specifications, they list all the vital elements in which compliance is required in order to maintain the level of quality that is required in terms of general construction, standards for occupational health and safety, for environmental management, quality assurance for traffic management, for quality control and testing, for clearing and grubbing, rock fill, stabilization of earthwork materials, materials for pavement construction, and all the nitty-gritty details of ensuring conformance to standards. So having these standards in place, and then the second step is to try to make sure that the contractors that they hire, they adhere to these standards. FRJ ensures that they engage contractors, produce works of quality and accuracy of detail to the requirements of the specifications and drawings. And in relation, they try to make sure that they bring on board contractors that have the type of experienced workers, foremen, surveyors, etc., other technical staff, together with the right equipment and instruments and equipment to ensure that the company itself, the contractor, can deliver the kind of work that is needed. And this, they will also expect the contractor, the engaged contractor, to be carrying out all the examination and testing of the materials that they use in accordance with the requirements of the specifications. The other aspect of a quality control that is used is making use of the numerous tools that they have, such tools as the technical review of FRA roadwork standards, the FRA standard drawing requirements, the code of practice for temporary traffic management, the manual of traffic signs and markings, and many more similar guides that the FRA uses to guide and ensure quality control. This is important as they provide additional guides or clarification to specific design information and procedures. So the various systems and processes in place are all to ensure that Fiji has the best possible roads that we can have. The other way, other area that is also addressed in terms of quality control is to raise awareness. By ensuring quality services, they're also proactive on social media through Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, and public awareness of roadworks. This is done to ensure that the traveling public manage their travel time to minimize delays or congestion as much as possible. Fourth element they try to do in managing control of the quality is to strengthen their own capacity within FRA in terms of getting the right people to do the job that is required within FRA. That is people that with the right knowledge, the right experience, the right qualifications, people who are well versed with the overall management, contractual obligations, the time and cost aspects of the contracts, planning and executing the works, implementation of work discipline on-site and off-site, and also who are able to manage the various complexities that are involved in management of in development of roads. Fifth aspect that they use is quality control to try to enhance the data that they have, quality control of data, better quality data to work the projects that they do, the enhancement of their GIS-based system that registers all of their assets and plays a key role in prioritizing maintenance, renewals, and new road construction. I think that in a nutshell, Mr. Speaker, says some of the major components of the things that FRA tries to use to enhance the quality of the assets that they are expected to maintain and develop. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. There's two aspects of roads. One, you have to have roads that you need to maintain to keep them up to a level where they don't disintegrate. As roads begin to disintegrate much more, that road has to be totally rehabilitated. So some of the roads that we're having now in Fiji, where there's a lot of potholes, these roads have gone past their serviceability lifespan. They need to be totally rehabilitated. Unfortunately, we have quite a number of these roads. So when we have a lot of these roads around, what we need to do at FRA, because they don't have all the contractors and the funds at all times to rehabilitate all roads, they will have a planned program to rehabilitate some, and those that they are not going to rehabilitate immediately, they try just to patch them up until they come to the time when they can rehabilitate. For instance, this week I've had some questions about the roads between, is it Bain Tabua? Batawa, yeah, so Batawa. In that particular stretch of road, FRA has got a plan to get the contractor on board by the month of May. So in the meantime, what they do, before they await that time, they completely rehabilitate the road. That means they rip everything out, that they fix the whole road. In the meantime, they will do some small patch-ups on the potholes that are there. There are some other places where you have some potholes after they've done the resealing, that there are some small potholes pot up. They crack up. Those ones, they also have a planned approach to try to remedy those potholes that they come up. So I think the intention over the long term is to completely eradicate all potholes, to build the roads up to a standard where we don't have them. But it's going to take some time, because some of the roads that we do have, the surface of the roads is in a condition that we just basically have to rehabilitate the whole thing. Ultimately, over the long term, we'll have a We need to have a number of plans. One, for the sealed roads. The unsealed roads, to bring them up to a certain standard. And the sealed roads that we do have, make sure that we can bring them up to a better standard where we can remove all the potholes. So, Mr. Speaker, in the meantime, while the potholes that are there, as much as possible, we don't want to keep on spending a lot of money on potholes. But if you have to rehabilitate this length of road, you can't rehabilitate at all at once. You rehabilitate that much, the rest you keep on filling the potholes until you can rehabilitate the rest of the road in the road development. Thank you, Mr. Speaker, sir.
Thank you, Honourable Minister. Honourable Federico Sinibo.